Hello, my name is Neil with KE2 Therm Solutions. The installation instruction provides very clear view of the back of the controller, easily identifying all of the electrical components. Each relay is a dry contact with which will you need to provide the power to be delivered to each control point. The controller comes with a terminal board that has several benefits. Number one, makes it easy to wire the controller. Two, it makes it easy to follow the wiring logic on future service calls. And three, provides fuse protection for the controller relays. Here we have a side-by-side view of the controller and the terminal board to be used at the evaporator. Depending on the power at the evaporator, your controller can be used for 120 volts or 208, 230 volts to run your refrigeration system. Just select the correct green pluggable connector for your application. This example uses 208 volts as the uninterrupted power source. Place black L1 in the L1 location as shown on the terminal board. The terminal board has all of the fuses pre-installed. Place red line 2 in the L2 location as shown on the terminal board. Place green ground in the ground location as shown on the terminal board. We should now have uninterrupted 208 volt power supplied to the terminal board. Install the correct voltage selector on the back of the controller as shown. From our factory, the selector is currently installed using the 208 230 volt selector. The next few steps are to bring the 208 volt power from the terminal board to the controller. Let's begin with line 2 as shown, using the white with red stripe. Now let's connect the ground from the terminal board incoming power to the controller using the green wire. Lastly, connect the black line 1 power on the terminal board to the controller using the black with the white stripe to L1 location as shown. The controller now has the potential to be powered. Next, the fan relay dry contact needs power provided to the common terminal. Connect the line 1 on the terminal board using the black with the blue stripe. Wire the common on the fan relay as shown. Connect from the fan relay on the normally open set of contacts using the blue with the black stripe. Wire to the blue-black location as shown on the terminal board. Next, the defrost relay dry contact needs power provided to the common terminal. Connect line 1 on the terminal board using the black with the orange stripe. Wire to the common on the defrost relay as shown. Connect from the defrost relay normally open set of contacts using the orange with the black stripe wire to the orange to the black location as shown on the terminal board. Next, the liquid line solenoid relay dry contact needs power provided to the common terminal. Connect line 1 on the terminal board using the black with the yellow stripe. Wire to the common on the liquid line solenoid relay as shown. Connect from the liquid line solenoid relay normally open set of contacts using the yellow with the black stripe wire to the yellow with black location on the terminal board. You should notice the wires are color coordinated as matched pairs to keep the installation and service very simple. There's one thing left for the electric defrost models is to use the existing high safety, also known as the high limit switch. Identify and install the safety switch as shown. Connect one side of the high safety switch to line 2 of the new terminal board. Connect the remaining side of the high safety switch to the bottom location of the spade terminal connections for the heating elements. All of the control wires connecting the new controller to the new terminal board are now complete. The only remaining wires to be installed are the fans, defrost heating elements, and the liquid line solenoid as shown on the right-hand side of the new terminal board. Simply follow the new wiring diagram to locate each of these wires for the complete install and for future service when service is needed.
For more information, please visit our website or contact our tech support, and we'll be glad to help.